basic MOSFET operation. Let's talk about the basic operation principle for a MOSFET. MOSFET stands for Metal Oxide Semiconductor Field Effect Transistor. The MOSFET is a type of controllable switch, which is essential for power electronic circuits. A MOSFET has three terminals: the gate, the source, and the drain. You can think of the gate terminal as the switch controller, and the source drain terminals as the switch. When the gate signal is high, current can flow from the drain to the source, but when the gate signal is low, current cannot flow. In power electronics, we send signals to the gate to control the current flow through the rest of the circuit. MOSFETs are very commonly used in power electronic circuits. Here, we will learn about the operation principle of a linear regulator, which steps down the voltage from one DC source to a DC load. The linear regulator is based on a resistor divider, but utilizes a transistor called a MOSFET as a variable resistor to accurately maintain a target output voltage. The operation of a MOSFET is a little complicated, but we will break it down and focus on how it is used in a linear regulator power converter. Here we'll talk about how we can use a MOSFET to help with a linear rectifier. So we're going to talk about how it can act as a variable resistor and how we can use that for power conversion. First, let's just talk about the basics of this metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Here we can see the basic schematic for it. We have a drain, a gate, and a source terminal. So three different terminals. And the way that we turn on this transistor is we put a voltage over the gate and source, like this. So VGS, when we have a voltage on these two nodes, we can allow current to flow through the transistor, the MOSFET, from the drain to the source. We can think about this as a graph, which we'll show on the right, and we're going to think about it in terms of how the current changes, ID, the current through the transistor changes as we change the voltage from the drain to the source. So this voltage across from the source to the drain, how our current depends on that voltage. When there's zero voltage, there's going to be no current through our system. So we're just at point zero. We're going to assume that our gate has some voltage on it. We're going to say, just for simplicity, it's going to be 4 volts. We start at zero. As we increase our voltage, our drain source voltage, our curve will look something like this. It'll start out a little bit linear, start to increase quickly, and then as we increase our voltage more, it will begin to saturate. So we can call this region saturation. And this is generally how we think about we're using a transistor. Usually you put voltage to the gate, it turns the system on, the switch on, and then current flows through it at a fairly constant rate. This would be in the saturation region. However, there's also this linear region where it's going from zero to that saturation current. We call that the linear region. And if you think about this voltage over our system and the current, you can see that as we increase our voltage, our current increases approximately linearly in this first region. So we can say that in this region, our MOSFET is actually acting like a resistor. So like a resistor. So if we set some voltage, we can see in this linear region, it'll act like a resistor. Then once we go to saturation, it has a fairly constant current. Let's look at how this changes when we change our voltage. So now we're going to assume our voltage from gate to source is going to be a little bit lower. So let's say instead of 4 volts, we're going to say it's 2 volts. We're again looking at the current through the drain, ID, and we're looking at the voltage over from the source to the drain. Again, if it's 0 volts, we're going to have no current through it. And as we increase our voltage, we are going to get a linear region, and then it's going to start to saturate after we hit a certain point. And here, again, and this is the linear region, we can see our system acts like a resistor. But this time, if we look at the difference, we have two different angles here. One, before it was a very steep angle, and now, at a lower gate voltage, we have a lower angle here. So these are like two different valued resistors. So what we can do is we're going to focus on this linear region for our system. So here is our basic graph of these two voltages. So say we had VGS equal to 4 and a lower gate voltage, VGS equal to 2 volts. We can focus on this linear region and we can see that we can change our gate voltage, VGS here, and we make it look like a different resistor value. So by changing the gate voltage, we can change the effective resistance that we're going to see from this transistor. Taking this basic concept, we can put this back into our resistor divider. So let's go back to the resistor divider, and let's go back to our old setup. We have Vin, some sort of DC input voltage, and then we have our load resistor here. We're going to call it R2, like before, and our output voltage is shown here. This time, we can use our controller and our MOSFET, and we can control it like we just explained to make it act like a variable resistor. So, using this controller, based on the input voltage that we read, we can change the resistance here, you can call it R1, resistance through this R1, which is a variable resistor, and change our resistance to make sure that our output is always maintained at 5 volts. So using this system, we use a MOSFET that's controlled in the linear region to act like a variable resistor, and we can step down a higher DC voltage to a lower DC voltage here and maintain a desired output voltage. So far, we have introduced the MOSFET and its basic operation. We've shown how a MOSFET can be used in the linear region to act as a variable resistor, and how that variable resistor is then used in a linear regulator circuit to achieve a specific output voltage. Linear regulators are commonly used in low-power electronics. For example, you'll find linear regulators in most portable electronics, providing a steady voltage to small processors or controllers in the device. One limitation of the linear regulator is that the power efficiency, the power output divided by the power input, is proportional to the output-to-input voltage ratio. In other words, in many cases, linear regulators are very inefficient DC-DC converters, so they are best used in low-power applications.